Hello everyone and welcome to our webinar today. Today we're going to be presenting about smarter security surveillance with Milestone Systems and Dell Technologies. Let's have a quick introduction to our speakers today. We have with us Pat O'Duffy, the solution architect for IoT and CCTV covering EMEA region. Haider Mohammed, the community manager for Middle East, Africa and Turkey region. Let's start with a quick introduction to Milestone Systems. Milestone Systems is the award-winning video management platform that enables the hardware technologies, applications that may be produced directly by Milestone or coming from its technology partners like Dell EMC or other hardware partners like producing cameras, since we're talking about video, and it could be the application partners producing the video analytics, access control systems, so on and so forth. Milestone Systems is having 1,800 plus solution partners. Dell Technologies is obviously one of them, offering us their hardware infrastructure for our solutions. We are very proud to stand out in the industry today with having more than 9,000 cameras integrated natively onto Milestone platform coming from 170 plus manufacturers globally. A quick look into the end customer solution stack. If we can segment the complete solution into three layers. We're talking about the hardware layer, which is the bottom layer, and that's where the infrastructure partner comes into play. For instance, Dell EMC, offering the workstation, storage, network, and other hardware components. The top layer, which is the application layer, that's where our application partners offering us the video analytics, artificial intelligence technologies, access control systems, and other applications. In the bottom, we have the Milestone platform layer. Milestone platform couples these layers together to offer a complete solution stack to the customer that it helps in eradicate their pain points and offering them a complete solution to fulfill their requirements. The open platform. The open platform is something that is in the DNA for Milestone since the inception. Milestone truly believes in enabling these niche technologies coming from our technology partners and coupling them with our software component, thus offering the best-in-class solutions to our customers. Milestone works with our technology partners like Dell Technologies to offer a complete solution to its end customer. The seamless integrations into access control systems, video analytics, or the hardware partners like producing the reference architectures, benchmark validations, thus offering a complete optimized solution to its customers. Open APIs plays a very important role. That's where our developer community or our in-house custom development plays a very important role using our software APIs to even customize the existing functionality, add new functionality, or even using our APIs to deliver new functionality to our customer based on their requirements. All of these solutions and all of these partners like Dell Technologies are fully validated and certified by Milestone. The benchmarks that Pat is going to talk about, you are rest assured that it is validated and it is the guaranteed performance that will be delivered once you choose to work with these reference architecture that Pat is going to present later in the slide deck. So in the end, the end user gets this peace of mind that solution that or complete solution stack that he's getting for his requirements is fully verified, validated, and it will deliver the performance that he's looking for. If you look at the platform, Milestone platform, that's how it looks like. Milestone platform layer sits in the middle, and all the niche technologies coming from our solution partners, be it camera hardware partners like Dell Technologies, body-worn cameras, drones, point-of-sale system, RFID systems, access control, video analytics. We work with our technology partners offering these technologies that they work in, and bring them together onto our platform to offer a complete solution to our customers. With all these subsystems working on Milestone platform, we are talking about tremendous amount of data, a tremendous amount of video data that is coming in the form of edge devices like cameras, the IoT sensors. We're talking about data coming from the point of sales machines, the video analytics data, and many other subsystems that are generating a lot of data. So you need a platform that is very high performance platform that can ingest all this data coming from many subsystems. Again, Milestone is very proud to state that Milestone is offering one of the highest performing recording servers in the industry today, having the ingest rate of 3.1 gigabit per second on a single recording server. Now that server is what Dell Technologies offers us to enable us to deliver this kind of performance. With 3.1 gigabits ingest rate on a single recording server, we are talking about thousands of cameras, depending obviously on the bitrate, but you can have 1,000+ cameras on a single recording server, thus reducing the overall hardware footprint and at the same time reducing the total cost of ownership. Some of the other complementary technologies that we heavily invest on is the hardware accelerating video decoding, which I'm going to be talking about later in my webinar. Multi-stage archiving, use of edge storage, SQVR, patent pending technology, multi-live streaming, the use of unicast and multicast in combination. And all of these features and technologies we can talk about later in detail if you wish to, or we can have another session, or you can post me queries, or you can have one-on-one session with me where we can talk about these in detail. With all this data coming onto the Milestone platform, obviously the security these days plays an absolutely vital role. Again, Milestone invests very heavily, a lot of R&D investment into this particular segment, the platform security. We have hardening guide that we offer to our customers that helps them to completely secure their platform with all these data coming from different subsystems. The features like Kerberos user authentication, HTTPS communication, bidirectional encryption, password protection, digital signature, certificate-based encryption, two-step verification are some of these features that you can use to protect your environment, to protect your platform with all these subsystems working together. The hardening guide that I spoke about earlier, which will guide you actually to prevent your system from the edge, the stream coming from the edge device to the stream getting recorded onto the recording server and storage with complete end-to-end encryption and all the security procedures around it. So have a look into our Milestone Systems Hardening Guide, and you can really benefit out of it by finding out the different ways on how to secure your security platform. Hardware acceleration, which I spoke about earlier, Milestone works with its technology partners like NVIDIA and Intel to make use of the GPUs that these technologies offer. Milestone has optimized its software code to make use of these GPUs to decode the video, not only on the operator workstation, on the Milestone smart client that is used to view the cameras for live viewing and playback, which operators uses, the interface that the operator uses, but also on the back end, the recording servers to process the video. Thus, using these GPUs, Milestone can really optimize the requirement, when the compute requirement that is required to run these applications. Now, thus, by reducing the CPU usage, you have a lot of free CPU that may not be utilized by Milestone application, but you can use it for other third-party applications like video analytics, LPR applications, access control systems. So if you combine all this together, you get a infrastructure which is fully optimized with reduced hardware footprint, and you get a system that can reduce the total cost of ownership using this hardware acceleration. Hardware acceleration, we believe, will play a very key role in future with all these AI-based algorithms that we are talking about. We are talking about deep learning applications, which our customers are showing a lot of interest in. But the thing is that these applications, these algorithms require a lot of computing to process the video to run their algorithms. That's where I think Milestone plays a very key role by having this hardware acceleration in almost all the components, be it the smart client, the application that the operator uses, the recording servers to process the video in the backend of the recording servers, and even the mobile client to use our mobile applications to transcode the video. On all these components, we make use of hardware acceleration, and we can even do the parallel processing on these NVIDIA GPUs. You can have a machine where you can slot in multiple GPUs, and you can really optimize your hardware by having this parallel processing on the GPUs. Another great initiative by Milestone, the launch of Milestone Marketplace. Milestone Marketplace is the online knowledge hub that connects Milestone technology partners and system integrators to in one place, where you have a wide range of verified hardware and applications that works together with Milestone, that are integrated with Milestone and complement Milestone XProtect. So the users can log in to Milestone Marketplace, and you can explore different solutions into different subsystems like video analytics. You can explore different hardware technologies. You will also find Dell Technologies listed here. I highly encourage you that you log into Milestone website, explore Milestone Marketplace, and have a look at these great solutions and technologies that are coming from our community partners. So based on your requirements, I'm sure you'll find many, many solutions coming from our technology partners, and you can look into those to build up your complete solution, and you can choose one that best fits your requirement. It also gives you the additional functionality or additional information on be it the user guides, be it the videos, the references, or even the customer testimonials on how these solutions have worked in their existing projects or in their existing install base. Like I said, I would highly encourage you to log on to Milestone Marketplace. Just go to Milestone website, search for Milestone Marketplace, and that's where you can also see information on Dell EMC Dell Technologies. If you want to know more, don't hesitate to email us hmu@milestonesys.com or pat.odafi@dell.com, and we'll be able to get back to you with your queries or more information that you may need. Milestone believes in innovation, and that is the proof of it. Milestone has decided to increase its innovation capacity by 45% in coming next 18 months. That means a lot of new R&D resources, a lot of investment on the technologies, and a lot of investment in building the platform with the latest innovations. That is one of the reasons you find that Milestone releases three releases in a year. Instead of waiting for one release a year, Milestone gets the market feedback, the feedback from our technology partners, the feedback from our resellers or our end users, and based on the market demands, we develop the new features and we release them. And that is the reason we have three releases, so that we bring the new features to the market quickly. Now I'm going to pass it over to Pat, who's going to talk about this great collaboration that is between Milestone Systems and Dell Technologies, and how we work together to offer you great solutions that is fully optimized and that can offer you the solution for your requirements.
Thank you very much for the introduction, Haider. My name is Pat O'Duffy. I'm a solution architect here at Dell Technologies. I'm based in Limerick in Ireland. Over the last couple of years, I've been working very, very closely with Milestone, and I'd like to go over some of the work that we've been doing here in the labs here and give you a general overview of Dell and Dell Technologies and where we sit in the surveillance space. So there's a brief overview of my agenda for the webinar there today. Basically, as I say, I'll be going through Dell Technologies and where we fit in the world of surveillance. We've got dedicated surveillance labs, and then, as I say, I'm going to focus on some of the work we've been doing in regards to milestone testing, in regards to the smart client at the front end, but also as on the VMS side, and see to go through some of the testings and findings that we've done in that space. And then I follow on from that, I'll be going through some of the storage options that we have to add on to your VMS, but also some of the foundation architectures, which is really where the future is being set, in regards to what hardware the VMSs and things like that, and analytics and things like that to do with surveillance can sit in an architecture point of view. I'll also do a brief overview of some of the networking options, and then very, very specifically in regards to the system builder program and the partnership that where Dell plays a role in that space, and give you a very, very good example of one of our strong partners, Seneca, in this space. So to start, basically, Dell Technologies have a very, very strong group that dedicated to supporting surveillance. We're number one in the global in the service or in the as an infrastructure provider in the space. We've got roughly about 34% of the global infrastructure of our market in here, and as I say, we've got a team globally that are focusing from a business development side, from a lab point of view, doing an awful lot of testing on the appliances and on the storage side, and bringing everything together. And as I say, I'll be going through some of these details further on in the presentation. So we all know that surveillance data is coming from everywhere, and it's really increasing as to the use case of surveillance and how things are being pulled together. Everything from the edge is really, really important, in regards to everything from body-worn cameras, more intelligence towards the edge. We've got mobile video or vehicle-based video, and even how you analyze that is becoming increasingly complex, but actually obviously interesting as well. You've got digital evidence, but analytics and things like that really play a really, really strong part in how things are being, or how things are progressing in this space. So why Dell Technologies? We've been investing heavily in this and really, really focusing on the surveillance market for over 10 years. As I mentioned, we've got a global team that are dedicated in supporting and really, really proving where surveillance works on Dell Technologies. We've got a market share leadership, which is obviously proving that point. As I say, we've roughly about a 34% global share market of the infrastructure. We don't do the camera side. We don't do the VMS side, but basically the underlying infrastructure is where we sit, and we've got everything from the edge to the core to the cloud, and we've a number of solutions and a number of options in that space. And again, as I say, I'll mention again that we've got a very, very trusted surveillance labs. We've got these are global labs that are dedicated towards testing VMS applications on Dell hardware and proving reliable reference architectures behind that. Now, where I'm based, as I say, I'm in the customer solution centres. We've got 19 centres globally. I'm based in Limerick in Ireland. My main focus is in the surveillance space and the IoT space and anything to do with surveillance. My workload is driven typically by the customer, what they demand and what they're looking for. And we're seeing a huge shift in the use cases of where people are using basically CCTV cameras and how they're applying them to their environments. To give you a very, very top level overview of what the Customer Solution Center is, our main workload is that we've like from a hand or from a self-service side of things, we manage interactive demos and hands-on labs. But the main workload of what I'm involved in is in regards to working directly with customers in regards to briefings, design sessions, and proof of concepts. The proof of concepts is proving obviously where the interesting spot is, and basically is it's where something is not understood. It's the capabilities are haven't. Might well have not been done before, and it's basically to try and set up a workload, set up the environment for a customer's application, and basically try and prove that all pulls together. And then from that, as I say, we have a number of analytics tools that we can analyze exactly how the system is performing, and the whole purpose of a proof of concept is to try and de-risk the investment that the customer is putting in and really prove that the application is actually running on the specific hardware and the hardware is up to that design. I tie very, very close. As I say, I'm based in Limerick, but just to show you here, this is our global network of solution centres, but where our surveillance labs are in Durham in the US and also Bangalore. We have roughly about 15 engineers globally that are focusing, and their whole life is focusing around basically managing the whole VMS, or managing the architectures and how VMSs and, as I say, increasingly analytics applications operate on Dell hardware, and the whole they basically derive things like work reference architectures and work paper and sizing guides basically on the workload that they do. As I say, I tie very, very closely into these labs, even though I report into the solution centers. But basically, a lot of the workload that I do will feed directly into these labs and into the global organization. As I mentioned, we've got the large. It is recognised as the largest surveillance-focused lab globally. We've got from the back end in the, both here and in the solution centre and in the labs. We've got infrastructure in the back end that we can generate thousands of high resolution, high bandwidth video feeds. We can also mix that. The main benefit of being able to generate consistent feeds is that you can derive a workload into an environment and basically test and calibrate it, but you can also repeat the test. So it's very, very crucial to have very, very controlled testing or test feeds in that space. I know specifically, obviously, that with Milestone, we leverage the stable FVS. It's obviously a very, very trusted tool within Milestone, but it's very, very capable and expandable in that space. But we can also introduce, as I say, we've got certainly in the solution center here, we've had customers that say, well, actually, yeah, we absolutely want to know, understand the workloads that are coming through. We also want to know the experience. So you want to if you want to mix that with live camera feeds, for example, live controllers, PTZ controllers and things like that as well. You're able to see basically the whole experience or the customer end user experience that you can pull that together. And that's where the solution centers really bring to light. They're focusing on a particular customer's requirements, and basically we're working on that to bring things forward, as I say, to really prove that something is actually working on the hardware that we believe it should work on. So the lab deliverables, basically, as I say, globally, there's a number of reference architectures that are very, very specific to Milestone. As I say, a number of these I've published myself, which I'll be going through later on in the presentation. But basically, we've got best practices on white papers, sizing guidelines, and configuration guidelines. These are all available on our global surveillance website. And they're going through a number of different options. As I say, it'll go from the edge side of things right through to your appliance side of things, but also very extensive research in regards to the storage entities and what options are available in that space. So just to give you a top level overview of really the test procedures and control points that we do within the labs. First off, it's always a functional test. Does the application actually work on the hardware? We push it though to a performance level to see how far we can push it, and really we're continuously monitoring all aspects of the system while we're pushing it through that performance phase. But then very, very critically is calibrated. So basically, from a calibrated point of view, as I say, we max it out to what we believe the performance will do. But a calibrated means that we want to run it off a full database. We typically will set that to an 80% a full disks or full or 80% of the disk used will be that database as such. And basically, we've got very, very controlled feeds going into that environment. We're trying to get them as a realistic test feed. But as I say, the main point of this is that we we want to make sure that there's pretty much like we're aiming towards a zero frame drop, and we're maxing this towards a real life, as close to real life as possible. But it's controllable, it's repeatable, so we can start measuring tests. We can introduce new hardware if we need to. We can recalibrate and bring to that. So the whole, as I say, point of that is really to say, look, this is in a working environment. It's what it would be long term as such in a real world side of the scenario. But it's, as I say, it is in that controlled environment. But then at that point, once we have it calibrated, we'll introduce disruptive options. So if you want to what sort of impact will a drive removal have? Will a drive rebuild have? What about redundant paths to the system? And it's really to find out, look, how resilient is this, and how will it survive? As I say, you can push it to a very, very performance level and keep it there. But sometimes if you introduce this level of disruptive, you really are mechanisms. Like the whole aspect is we want to try and keep you at a maximum uptime, but also from a application point of view, that we're aiming towards that zero frame drops on that and being able to handle that. Some of the tools that we use, very, very specifically, I'm going to go through just some of the basics on live optics. This is a Dell developed tool. However, it's freely available, and it's available basically by any of our partners, and it'll basically run on an environment. You run it over a time period, and it basically gathers all your system specific information from that time scale. So if you want to run it for 4 hours or 24 hours or even a week, it'll run in the background on your appliance or on your system, and it's gathering basically the WNI information from the system. So it's pulling all your CPU information, your memory information, all your disk operations, and it dives deep into the disk side of things about what's actually happening. We will be introducing the likes of GPU support and things like that to this application very, very shortly. But at the moment, as I say, we'd normally combine this with a number of third-party tools, even from obviously NVIDIA. If we're looking, focusing towards it, NVIDIA, they have a GPU profiler that will do gather very, very specific information on the GPU adapter, split it out into the different sections, and you can analyze. But you're combining that with the information report from Live Optics, but also very, very importantly, the information within the Milestone application and the logs to do it, like we're following through to see, making sure we're monitoring the frame drops and things like that, and everything is operating as we'd expect. Once, as I say, we've got something calibrated to this level, it is at that point that we'd be able to pick our spot and work towards that reference architectures and things like that, and try and publish those to in depth. The live optics side, it's not unique to a single platform. It's not unique to Dell in the sense of what you can load it on. It's also, you can spread it across multiple multiple appliances, and it'll also monitor virtual spaces and even specific storage entities as well. You can load it across, as I say, it's an agent that's loaded on a particular system. You can push it to multiple systems, and it's typically the information is gathered and pushed to the cloud or the cloud interface for it. However, in the dark side situations and things like that, you can also run it locally and gather the information locally. It's not pulling specific information, it's only pulling the metrics and things like that. So it's a very, very useful tool for analyzing an existing environment. But as I say, we leverage it very, very heavily in the test environment as well. So going through some of the portfolio of what we have, as I say, Dell Technologies, we don't do the cameras and we don't do the VMS side or any of the applications that sit on top of that. However, we have an extensive range of products, everything from, if you're trying to look towards the edge, as we call it, as I say, if you're looking towards gateways or embedded products, are really things that are pushing towards talking to the cameras, as we say, sensors or anything to that level at the edge. From a switch side of things, we've got an extensive network portfolio that are geared and fine-tuned towards the surveillance space. But when you move back into the core, which is really where your command center is, where your recorder servers are, where you might need extensive external storage or SAN type NIC technology, we've a huge amount of offerings in this space. But however, we also have cloud services. So even our ECS, our Elastic Cloud Service platform, is extendable right into the cloud side of things. So as I say, anything on the infrastructure side, we can consider we do have a big part to play in that space. Just giving you a very, very top level of our edge computing portfolio. These basically are industrial grade compute nodes. From a very, very small connectivity side, we've got the Gateway 3000 series, typically in around automation, transportation. And not very, very high on processing capability, not very high on storage and the entity, but from a connectivity point of view, being able to monitor cameras remotely, to maybe do a very, very basic level of analytics. And as I say, storage is not a strong point in this particular product. However, from a size, from a positioning, where it fits, it does have a space on that connectivity side towards the edge. The 5000 is a bit better. Gateway 5000 is that bit larger as such. A little bit more compute if you're adding in quite a number of, say, additional sensors and things towards that space, that where that fits. Quite nicely though, the embedded PC 3000 or EPC 3000, this is quad core Atom based, 2.5 inch hard drive storage side of things. And it is in essence an edge compute node. We've tested this in our labs here with up to about 8 high definition cameras over about a week's period of time. And it is very, very capable at that sort of scenario. As I say, it is going into that environment. These PCs are typically tested, I know, from a minimum 0 to 50 degrees Celsius, but also, as I say, in extreme rates, we can put these into -30 to +70 degrees. From a stronger point, the Edge PC 5000, this is iCore based. So you can bring this up to an iCore 7. You've got dual hard drives in there. Very, very powerful machine in that sense of what it can do. But it's got the rugged side of things. You can embed this. These are measured with zero airflow. So they will go into that harsh environment that you may need. And again, these two particular products we have actually tested with Milestone and have some reference documentation towards those. The XE3 is actively cooled. So the interesting part of that, this will take a GPU, whereas the other products, because they're passively cooled, they don't. You don't have the capability of adding in the level of GPU or NVIDIA that you might want and want to leverage in the space. But as I say, the XE3, very, very powerful machine. In the environment it'll go into, these are very, very, these are long life products. It's got the inclusion of dust masks for going into the harsher environments. As I say, it does have active cooling within the system. It is in essence a desktop, but and being industrialized to go into the harsher environments and being capable of running the 24/7 operations, and as I say mentioned, leveraging the level of the likes of GPU, which in this particular, obviously in the case of Milestone, is very, very important from the front end, but also possibly or potentially on the VMS side of things. So our viewing work sort of workstation platforms, just to start off on that side. From a Dell side, we've got a number of different ranges of desktops, as we call them, from our OptiPlex range to our Precision range. The Precision range is really the T3630 and the T5820, typically is what we have at the moment. Is that these are aimed really at high-end 24-hour usage, and I've specific reference architectures in these two particular products, really, of how they scale, how they leverage NVIDIA, and how they level with the Milestone, or they scale with the Milestone side of things. Just some of the kind of considerations that we have in regards to the GPU considerations that we have. From a very, like, as I say, some of the reference architectures will go into a lot deeper as to what this is and explaining of it. But typically, a GPU or graphics adapter, it has a number of basic components, from a decoder to an encoder, and then CUDA cores and memory and processing within that particular adapter. From an NVIDIA side of from a Milestone side of things, you're very, very heavily leveraging what's known as the NV decoder. And it'll go into hopefully some of the details and how that scales later on. But really what we're looking towards is, as I say, that the Quadro, You can look at the GTX side of things from a home side of things, but they are not typically designed. They are designed for performance, but they're not designed for 24/7 operations going into harsher environments and going into performance environments. The NVIDIA Quadro range of products, basically the P series, and they These are designed basically for 24/7 operation. They're fully tested and qualified under our workstation platforms. They typically have common display outputs, quad port, display port options. So if you're connecting up multiple monitors, they will scale to that level. They've long product life cycle in that sense, and going, which isn't really a problem at this stage, and all the current shipping adapters do support H.264 and 265 decoding, but worth keeping in mind there's multiple revisions in that. You are best going for the latest adapter to really make sure that you're covering all aspects of the decoding and of what's coming through to the adapter and being able to support it. So these some of the just an example of the smart client design considerations, and taking in this particular account the T5820. This we have a reference architecture that is available on Milestone's marketplace, so it is available to you. It is available for download, and it's available on our own site as well. But this is, as I say, it's a reference architecture that we're going through multiple different configurations of this particular platform to see how it scales. So the consideration, like what about adding a P600 or the NVIDIA P2000 integration with the Intel QuickSync, and typically say with no hardware acceleration as well. So as I say, depending on the platform, Milestone leverages GPU acceleration basically for on the smart client, typically for pushing out more displays and taking the load from the CPU onto the GPU and pushing out basically to how many, like basically from a resolution side of things, how far can you push it, how many streams can you play back on that particular client. You do leverage the Intel QuickSync, for example, which is based on the Intel video GPU, which is physically on the processor, but also, as I say, very, very scalable with on the NVIDIA side, NVIDIA adapters, and it'll also support multiple NVIDIA adapters. It'll also support the Intel with the NVIDIA. So, as again, you can get a very, very scalable platform in that space. As I say, the reference architecture, we'll go into an awful lot more detail in this, but the fee does quite a number of different things that will affect how many. So the lower the resolution, the lower the frame rates and things like that, the more displays you can put on your smart client side of things. However, if you start increasing the frame rate, increasing the resolution, that brings it down. The other consideration on the client side, as I say, it's very important to note that from a P600, for example, which is towards the entry level of the Quadro side, we've even looked at the P4000, which is very, very high end on the Quadro side. There's a finite size, which is the NV decoder of what's that. So these adapters typically from your low end to the hot, so that you've got the same NV decoder chipset that's on the P600 versus the P4000. From a performance point of view, you see very, very little difference between the P600 and the P4000 in regards to the amount of information it can push to the smart client side of things. So in this case, you can say, well, actually, look, there really isn't a point in pushing P4000s into the platform versus the P600. You are better with the P600. However, when you're looking towards multiple monitors and pushing out to multiple displays and higher resolution displays, it's at that point that you really need to consider, okay, let's move from a piece from the lower end P600 up to even the P2000 or beyond. But the P2000 is what we believe is an optimum for up to about 4K displays, and being able to render that. But if you're looking for multiple for a large single display and multiple feeds to it, that's where you're looking towards that lower end adapter. And as I say, the reference architecture will go into that, and it goes into that in more detail. Yeah, this is another very interesting architecture that I wanted to just go through in a little bit more detail. Again, it's up on the Milestone marketplace, but the Dell R740 XD is a 2U server appliance. You can have up to 18 physical 3.5-inch hard drives in the system, so it's very, very capable on localized storage within the product itself. You can also have what's known as a Dell Boot optimized card, or it's a PCIe adapter with dual and or M2 NVMe adapters on it. So very, very useful for hosting the operating system on that. And that means you can leverage basically the whole of the 18 hard drives for your database side of things. So what we've done in this particular architecture, I've run through five separate configurations to basically show you how it scales. So from a single CPU SATA drive configuration to dual CPU SATA configuration. But what sort of impact does SAS drive to introducing SAS disks into the environment have? So we completely swapped out all the 18 SATA disks for SAS disks, rebuilt the whole environment and set it up. And that typically gave us roughly about a 33% improvement going between SATA and SAS. And then we introduced the likes of a single GPU. In this case, our testing was done on the P4, NVIDIA P4 Tesla adapter. And then we scaled the P4 to multiple P4s. Now, there's a number of considerations to be had when you're working on the appliance side of things. As a VMS. So basically, really your key on the network side of things about what's coming in, how much bandwidth is coming into your system, but also very, very importantly, how quick can you process it? And that's where you're leveraging typically CPU and obviously scalable on the GPU side of things. But really, really, what's critical as well is your I/O performance of your disks. So any one of those can be a limiting factor to how many streams can you pull into a particular platform, and you really want to fine tune these. As I say, you can push these to its limits. I've set up an R740 with six NVIDIA P4 GPUs, full SSD structure on the hard drives, and again, a very, very capable machine. We were able to push that up to about 1400 high definition feeds with full motion detect, and being able to process them and store them on the hard drive. The limiting factor though, that is your extreme case, but you've got a very, very short retention time on that particular platform, very, very high costs obviously, and then you're pushing like multiple GPUs in there, and do you really want to put 1400 camera feeds to a single appliance? But it does show the capabilities of how your software scales, how it pushes forward, and how it leverages GPU for its decoding side of things. But as I say, in our reference architectures, as I say, we're looking, if you're looking for high retention time, however, lower camera count, that's what you should be looking towards, the SATA configurations and the lower CPU side of things. If you're looking towards better performance and you're optimizing it and you're pushing towards it, that's where you're starting to introduce the GPU side of things, SAS configurations. And the whole idea is to try and get a balance of performance versus storage and on how you want to push through that. And going through the reference architecture, as I say, we did have to introduce the likes of even SSD to a level where, just from a disk side of things, to be able to be capable of being able to basically store the information from the GPU side of things. This is a new product that we've only recently released. Very, very based. It's based on the R740 architecture, except we're calling it the R740 XD2. It's got a slightly lower performance motherboard side of things. It does not support the likes of GPU. However, is a very, very heavy disk orientated system. We've got 26 3.5-inch disks that can fit into this chassis, plus your boot optimized cards. Again, you can get over 300 terabytes of usable storage within a 2U platform. So again, a very, very capable system for the surveillance market. Now, I just want to move on to some of our storage entities, basically just to give you an idea of where we fit on the storage side. We've got the small side of things, which is typically on the appliance side of things. But if you want to add in additional storage, where do you go to, or what can you do, and how far can you go to? Where does it come into? We've got a number of products from our Paravolt ME range, our SC range in Unity. And when you start going into the higher level storage end, which is typically a petabyte and above, but that's where it realistically becomes more available. We've got our Isilon, Unity will scale up into this space, ECS, but very interesting as well, we've built out a foundation architecture called the IoT solution for surveillance, and I'll go into that in a little bit more depth later on. So our ME series, these are typically bolt-on storage entities. They will do direct connects, a SaaS if you need that, or also iSCSI connections as well. You can get in the ME, the 4084, again, it's a very, very dense unit. You can get 84 3.5-inch disks in this particular platform. It scales typically 1, 2, 3 servers aside on the front end, but it is, as I say, that, and then you can block it to bring to it to multiple entities if you want to scale it sideways as such. But it is, as I say, if you want low cost bolt-on storage that you really, really want to scale, you can push the ME series is very, very capable in that space. These are the typical drive supports that we have in that. As I say, it'll go through everything. Mostly in the surveillance space, we're looking towards like retention time, not typically performance when we're in the storage side of things. So you are looking at the 3.5-inch disk options and how that scales and how you can push that. So, Bria, this is one of our high end storage entities, Isilon, very, very prevalent in the surveillance space. One of the key options on that, and I've got a very, very good slide that really covers this later on, is our OneFS file system. Basically, it's a single file system that multiple entities on the front end can all talk to a single file system within the storage array. Very, very simple for manageability. If you need more storage across any of your front end components, it's all in a single space. You just add on another Isilon product, and if you want to boost it up. So very, very scalable if you're in a dynamic environment that you're adding cameras, moving cameras, or shifting between nodes. And basically, it'll mix its performance. As I say, it's auto balancing about capacity plus performance across the whole node. So it's very, very resilient on the manageability point of view, very, very simple to use. resilient as such as well is it makes the maximum use really of the storage space available. You've got load balancing within there, so all of this is all preset within the configuration of the Isilon product. So it's very, very, as I say, it's really there to really maximize the performance on your back end, and as I say, it's very, very scalable. As I say, scalable and efficient. Overall, as I say, we're aiming towards about 80% and above on a storage utilization. So this is, as I say, it's very, very, you're really maximizing where it fits into like when you're looking for long retention times, lots of cameras. This is where Isilon really, really extends what it can do. And it is typically with a Milestone side of things. Yes, it's a object-based storage, so it does need a stepping stone. So you are typically running your live volume on the localized front-end appliances side of things. And this is typically your archive side of things. But again, the whole key point of Isilon is very, very easy to manage and scales really, really, as I say, okay, and this documentation is up to 60 petabytes, but it will go well beyond that now at this stage. So this is just giving you an example of why like certainly if you've, in this case, we've got four, say, NVRs on the front end, maybe having 100 or 200 cameras apiece, and this is the normal operation on your traditional side of things. Each one of these silos, though, really have to be managed on their individual method. So if what happens, say for example, if you want to migrate data from one place to another, it is really working. These are all independently working toward or working with so they're not working together as a unified platform. Whereas if you look if you've got a single file system. As I say, the disadvantage, what happens on the traditional side, if you want to add in, say, 20 cameras on the first appliance, you'll have to focus on it and basically almost bring down the system to really add on the extra driver capacity and things like that you have. Having a single file system, if you need to extend it, it's all automated. As I say, it doesn't matter where it'll load balance across all your appliances to say, well, actually, look, yes, we do need additional storage on the first node. We needed to shift cameras from the third node to the second node. All of that from a storage entity, everything is, as I say, because it's on a single file system, very, very easy to use. So it's uniform, very, very automated, and it's very, very simple to manage. I did mention this. This is one of our foundation architectures. Very, very exciting about where this fits in the industry. This is taking a new idea or a new approach, basically, to how you manage surveillance data in a large capacity. Again, for this particular solution, we've got a full reference architecture sizing guide for Milestone specific to yourself and how this works. It is It is certainly a maturing technology in the sense that in the architecture, as I say, we're adding in. So the foundation base architecture, typically the way it's running a hyper-converged front end, giving you resilience and performance where you need it. But then on the back end, from the initial architecture was leveraging ECS. That kind of, we have looked further into regards to putting Isilon on the back end, and also in regards to adding in what happens if you add in analytics to this. And again, we're looking towards blade type architectures in this space. But going into it a little bit more detail from the hyper-converged side of things, it is all based around VMware front end architectures. So you've got vCenter, vSphere, vSAN. That is allowing you being able to very, very simply orchestrate exactly what's happening out there. From a management point of view, if you need to add in another node, or sorry, add in another another milestone, say if you want to add in another 100 cameras and put in another recorder server, you can orchestrate that and push that out as an additional server. We've integrated Pulse IoT management. Quite simply, that's a device management side of things, but being able to talk to your cameras and being able to figure out what's happening on the device side of things. And then when you move off towards the Platinum side of things, you can do an awful lot on the network orchestration. We can leverage Pivotal from a container point of view. And again, it is managing that whole ecosystem really that's pushing and being able to give you performance, resilience, and very, very scalable in this space as well. This is really just talking over the same again, typically, but as I say, you've got your servers on the front end, they're all VMware based. Because you're leveraging the virtualization in regards to the server side of things, the storage side of things, NSX for your network side of things, you can have a whole node failure on the front end, and basically your live volume is all completely up and running. As I say, you've still got access to the data that was recorded, even though the server might have been on node one, for example. It'll come up on node two, but it's still access to your live volume as you're there. So it's very, very resilient on that front end. Also built for performance is typically SSD that is a foundation from a performance architecture in that space. But then on the back end, as I say, we've leveraged ECS, which is a Elastic Cloud Service, which can be on-premise or going to push to cloud. We can also do Isilon on that back end as well and push, depending on what situation is there. But we've multiple architectures on that. The reference architectures are typically up on our own website. We've got sizing guides for Milestone. So we're working very, very heavily and absolutely leverage from the solution center to our business development guys. If there are larger projects then that you want to work towards, we can absolutely get some sizing in towards those for you. This is the architectural functions, say an example with Milestone, basically what's happening. This is typically what the product side looks like. So you got your management side of things on the top end, networking on the very, very top, and then your tier one storage and processing side, typically as your servers on your front end. This is your vSAN side of things. This is your real hyper-converged infrastructure. And then tier two, this is your video storage, basically where things are being pushed onto on the back end or archiving to. So from our networking portfolio, again, everything from the from your fabric switches within your data center, top of rack side of things, your end series typically, or your branch side of things. These also, the end series, very, very important if you're looking for PoE, PoE plus support on the front end, and that level of architecture from that space as well. We also have some very, very strong partners that we work with in regards to the wireless space, Aerohive and Ruckus in particular. We have a number of architectures we've been working with them. For example, in transportation, we've leveraged Ruckus Mesh for offloading of high volumes of data from a vehicle into the data center. And again, reach out if you need any information or further information in that space. This is just a top level overview of the use case. Look, networking, just to highlight it, we are absolutely in that space, and we have a range all the way through from the edge to the core, and even extension out to the cloud side of things. So very, very top level. This is to give you an idea of some of the proof of concept activity that we've been going through within the labs here. This is the type of stuff that's coming into the labs. It's what customers are looking for. It's what they're looking for, an awful lot more than just, hang on a sec, we've got cameras, we want to be able to store the information and obviously retain it. But we're getting very, very interesting proof of concept activity in regards to transportation. So federated architectures, wireless offload, using the likes of Milestone Interconnect to pull things together, PSIM integration, IoT integration, top-level overviews, being able to view maps of cities, being able to pull IoT information into that. Analytics playing a huge part as well. How do you integrate the analytics with your VMS side of things? What sort of data can you get from that? That's pulling in, as I say, there's a whole new set of customers in this space. They're not looking for, say, you've got the police forces are looking for specific identification of people, identification of cars and things to that level. But you've got the likes of city managers looking for, actually, look, we're on a heat map, traffic going through, how many cars, how many trucks went through our city, where do people actually typically walk, where are they congregating, and things like that. So analytics is playing a really, really part and opening up new customers that are very much leveraging CCTV technology. Number of interesting projects in regards to virtualization, VDI, GPU, leveraging on the front end, also on the back end, how does it go into that virtual advised environment? So we've number of very, very specific customer use cases in that. And again, as I say, another very interesting architecture in regards to 5G. We've got a research organization within Dell, and from the Solution Center, we're helping them on use cases within the surveillance space. So how do you leverage 5G? One particular function is the multi-access edge computing, which is a dynamic method of being able to push your processing power more towards the ISP, towards the control towers. So you're able to shift your analytics basically, say, around a city and integrate with vehicles and things like that. So as I say, watch this space. This is something that's coming on the future. It's down the line a little bit in this stage, but we're testing that in the labs here, and that's some of the work that we're involved in. So from a system builder point of view, where did Dell sit? We typically, we're a community enabler for system builder. We're leveraging our own reference architectures and things. We're doing a lot of the work in our back end labs out here. We're helping basically our OEM partners. Our route to market typically is with our OEM partners. We're helping them size, we're helping them configure their appliances and push them to market. And there's multiple, depending on the globe, we've got multiple partners in this space that we are helping to get their products to market. One in particular, I just want to go through some of the advantages, basically, why you go with an OEM rather than going direct with Dell, for example. Seneca is a brand. It's a video surveillance brand that's tailored. They build tailored Milestone NVRs. Seneca is a brand from the Arrow global organization, so they have a very, very strong reach and being able to reach the end customers and be able to deliver it. But these are the underlying hardware across all their products are all Dell. They're all Dell hardware pieces that are the basis from their client side of things to their NVRs and the storage entities and how they all pull together. But these are all certified basically for Milestone. So they've gone through the whole system builder certification program. The Seneca brand is adding a number of additional factors that really outlay your data. They go beyond really. They're tailored towards surveillance. So these are optimized when you've got a first boot experience that is very, very tailored towards Milestone. So it's got everything that's in there that you actually need. If you want to set it up, for example, as a management server only, recorder server only, they've got all the insight basically at that front end experience when you get onto the system. As I mentioned, the NVR scale from the low end right the way through to that R740 XD that we mentioned earlier, but also on the smart clients, again, the very, very low end right the way through, they'll scale through, and then as I say, expandable storage. They've got an online sizing tool, very, very useful, very, very key. So they've pretty much your t-shirt size as a small, medium, large. What do you need to go for? How much cameras? How many cameras? What sort of bandwidth are you looking towards? And that will identify really the right product that you're looking towards. And then from a system management point of view, they have a number of add-ons that you can bolt on if you're looking to out-of-band management and pull really your whole surveillance structure from a camera to the NVRs and pull and being able to manage them as a single entity. And then very strong. And in regards to support, first line of support is typically through the Senega approach, and but they know this is a security appliance. They know basically that this is in a very high secure environment. So it is, as I say, from a they're leveraging Dell, but they're bringing this to market and wrapping around really everything that's critical to a surveillance market and bring it to you and to our own customer, our mutual customers. So really, to wrap things up, key takeaways really from that we wanted to get across to you this morning. Really to understand, we've got a from a Dell perspective, we've got a very strong focus on surveillance. We're a very strong team within Dell. We're here to help you. We're here to bring you to basically to work with yourselves and bring your products and basically to bring you to the end customer. We've got a wide range of infrastructure products, again, all the way from the edge to the core to the cloud. We've got a dedicated surveillance team that are really we're here to help you from the, as I say, from the business development, the sales engineering side, from our lab side of things. These are all guys that got they're there to help you. The Customer Solution Center, we've got 19 of these globally. Everything from Europe, we've got from, as I say, I'm based in the Limerick labs. We've got Paris, Frankfurt, Poland, but also very importantly out in our Middle East, we've got Dubai. These centers can be leveraged by ourselves. There's no problem coming into it and bringing mutual customers in and leveraging them from that level of from a briefing to a design session to a proof of concept. So as I say, it's a very strong tool that you can leverage within your organization. So
with that, we have reached to the end of our webinar. Thank you very much for everyone who have joined us today. If you have any queries, please don't hesitate to reach out to us. We have shared our emails earlier. Reach out to us and we'll be happy to assist you with your queries or any information that you may need. So thank you very much.